سابقا تعلمنا that we have a and a will come in these shapes and a will come in these shapes. One is short صوت and one is long صوت. One will accept حركات and the other one will not accept حركات. Okay. ثلاثة اثنان واحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. مرحبا جميعا. أنا عز الدين and this is Learn Arabic with Z. كيف حالكم؟ Did you reply today? Good. اليوم we'll talk about a new thing. We call it تنوين. Now, do you remember these حركات? A, E, U. Sometimes we are putting double حركة. Not only one حركة, we are putting double. So it will be double فتحة, double كسرة, double ضمة. We are not just pronouncing فتحة, كسرة, or ضمة. We pronounce N. And this شكل, or this shape, or this sign will come only في نهاية الكلمة. What? What is في نهاية الكلمة? Does it mean in the starting of the word? No. By now, you should know that في بداية الكلمة means in the starting of the word and في نهاية الكلمة means in the end of the word. So this شكل will come only in the end of the word. في نهاية الكلمة. But how do you pronounce it? How can we pronounce it? As I said, in one ضمة it will be pronounced بو. We will put double حركة. Here we will put double ضمة. In double ضمة it will be pronounced بن. بن. Now we have سا. With كسرة it will be pronounced C. But when I put double كسرة it will be pronounced سين. سين. It will be written with two حركات. But it will be pronounced like if I'm putting نا. ن. Here for example we have را. With فتحة. If I put double فتحة it will be written like this. With آ. Only in تنوين فتحة. It will be with آ. We will not pronounce it. We will pronounce it رن. So you pronounce bun or bin or ban, sin or sun or san, run or rin or run. Also, this has some uses. Soon we will talk about this again and we will explain the meanings of this. Why Arabs changed shape from n to just double haraka. But now I just want you to understand that when you see double haraka, you will pronounce it haraka with n. If it's double haraka of kasra, so it will be si, sin, sin. It will not be سن for example. It will be سن كسرة with sound of ن. Now let's take examples in words. This مدرسة with ضمة. With double ضمة it will be مدرسة. We write it with double ضمة without ن but we pronounce it with ن. مدرسة. And here we have تاء مربوطة في نهاية الكلمة in the end but we don't pronounce it like ها because we didn't stop on it. There is no sukun, there is haraka. So it will be madrasatu or madrasatun. Another example, you have mal'abi. When we make a double haraka on B, it will be mal'abin. It will be written with double haraka, but pronounced with n. Mal'abin. Last example, you have walada. Walada. When we put double fatha, we said we will put a. We don't pronounce it. We just put a. And it will be pronounced waladan, waladan, like this. So from this lesson, we need to understand that when we put double haraka on any letter, we will pronounce it like the letter N in the end, the sound of N, like this. And it will only come في نهاية الكلمة, only in the end of the word. And I will tell you a secret, but don't tell anyone. There is a big problem between double haraka and L, and they will never come in the same word. If L came في بداية الكلمة, cannot put double حركة في نهاية الكلمة. If we want to put double حركة في نهاية الكلمة, we cannot put L في بداية الكلمة. As I said, we have some uses for this. We will talk about it later. We don't need to know it right now. From this lesson, I just want you to understand these three things. We cannot put L في بداية الكلمة and double حركة في نهاية الكلمة in the same word. Double haraka will only come في نهاية الكلمة, only in the end of the word. And we will pronounce N في نهاية الكلمة, in the end of the word. Now I want to tell you that this is the last lesson of level 1. After this lesson, we will have this. You will test yourself in level 1. Did you understand it or no? I hope if you can revise before you do the test. The test will be a video like this. You will find it as a new video coming. I want you to revise before taking the test. And when you take the test, be honest with yourself. I will tell you about the test in the test itself. And that's all for today. Looking forward to see you in the next video. See you soon. إلى اللقاء.